Hello everyone, my name is Vasilios Theodorou and I'm a senior research engineer with Intracom Telecom. Today I will present to you our work Blockchain-Based Zero-Touch Service Assurance in Cross-Domain Network Slicing, which is a joint work conducted in context of the Horizon 2020 project 5G Zoro. First, I will present some motivation about how our approach tries to tackle complexity in multi-stakeholder environments. Then I will present the solution that we propose using blockchain technologies and also an AIOps zero-touch architecture to encompass our approach. It will be followed by an evaluation and a prototype implementation and experimenting we have performed. And last, I will leave some time for questions and discussion. Let's first set up the context of our approach. So we envision an evolution of network service and network slices towards more open marketplaces where different operators and different service and resource providers will be able to register whatever services they wish. And through such marketplaces, they will be able to exchange services, to compose services from resources and services available, etc. And we can imagine many reasons for such a direction, such as new revenue streams, improved services, market openness that will create new opportunities, etc., etc. Nevertheless, we can also very easily see that such ecosystems will create new needs for secure and trustworthy operation of network slices. And this situation becomes even more complex if we consider that the different players, the different operators or service providers might not be and will not be a priori trusted. So we are not talking about only major traditional mobile network operators, which are very strictly regulated and so on. We can imagine many smaller players, many third-party providers who would like to enter the market, and there are many incentives for such an evolution to take place. So we can imagine the complexity of multi-domain network slicing, and in order to tackle such complexity, we need to come up with automation mechanisms for the orchestration, the management, and the operation of such services, and also making sure that the quality of those services remains at high levels despite any service spikes or any service unavailabilities which might occur, any security attacks which might occur from untrusted parties and so on and so forth. Recently, there have been a lot of works proposing blockchain technologies as a viable solution for tackling some complexities in multi-domain and multi-stakeholder marketplace environments. distributed ledger technologies or DLT technologies have been thus introduced in order, you know, to take advantage of some very interesting properties that they offer, such as non-repudiation, immutability, verifiability of transactions, etc. So they look as natural candidates to facilitate marketplace interactions in the form of transparent, traceable, and authenticated and authorized interactions. We also adopt such a scheme, but we take this one step further, and we advocate that if we look a bit more carefully into DLT technologies, we will see that they offer even more interesting properties, especially in enterprise blockchain technologies. And using some contracts that are called smart contracts, and they can contain some code, some logic that can be triggered under certain circumstances. So we find that using smart contracts and the smart contract logic embedded into them, we can achieve secure, proactive, and streamlined NFV mono-based mitigation of SLA violations. So we have two things. One is that smart contracts can be used as constructs to model service level agreements between different parties in this ecosystem of network service and resources, in order to formulate composite multi-domain, multi-stakeholder network slices. But we also see that these smart contracts and these agreements can also contain SLO service level objectives in the form of metrics to be monitored. They can also contain rules in the form of logic and code to be executed when some events are monitored are captured about these metrics. And using the smart contract properties, we can rest assured that an increased level of security and trust can be embedded into our system in order to streamline not only the network service marketplace, but also the service assurance. We employ DLT technologies for the management of service level agreements, lifecycle management. But let's see now how these smart contracts modeling integrates with the rest of our system in order to provide a full end-to-end solution for service assurance in multi-domain environments. To this end, and acknowledging that we are talking about versatile environments where both the resources and the management entities, the management technologies of these resources can be very different from one domain to the other, we advocate the use of recently introduced paradigm, which is called AI ops, and essentially it refers to the exploitation of AI and machine learning techniques towards IT operations. What it means in essence is that data about the health and the performance of different parts of a complex system are constantly monitored and correlated using machine learning techniques in order to inspect and identify real-time issues and to come up with actionable insights about what kind of mitigation actions can take place in order to avoid any performance outages, or in general to maintain the quality of service. So for 5G Zorro, what we understand as AI ops is an entanglement of this notion with the closed loop architecture that is has been introduced for the zero touch service management, and it has been inspired by ETSI ZSM working group. So we see on the right the feedback loop architecture that we introduce for 5G Zorro multi-stakeholder service assurance. Starting from the bottom left, we can see that there is a virtual resource manager, which is essentially the mano platform of a single domain, which is constantly observing and collecting monitoring data about the status and health of services and resources. This data is pushed and ingested into a data lake. And from there, if we go to top left of our figure, we can see all the SLA management related components, which essentially are the SLA monitoring, SLA breach prediction, and SLA management, which communicates with the smart contracts and the ledgers and provides some translation from smart contracts to our system. From there, from the SLA monitoring and breach prediction components, information is passed on to intelligence slice and service manager, which is top right of our figure, for it to decide and plan any potential corrective actions based on monitored events and notifications. And from there on, we go to the bottom right of our figure, and is the network slice and service orchestrator, which is actually the actuation component that directly enacts and influences the resources and services and instructs corrective actions, like, for instance, scaling out, etc. So all these components are communicating in an asynchronous manner through an integration fabric that we see in the middle. And a very important role is being played by the operational data lake of our system, which is essentially not only a repository for collecting all the data and all the monitoring data from the disparse systems, but at the same time, it is our operational environment for conducting the AI and machine learning tasks in a streamlined and automated way. To validate our approach, we employed a CDN use case using a commercial CDN solution, according to which there is some saturation on the resources of a communication service provider, which in turn is triggering the provisioning of resources over third-party infrastructure. So in this way, creating this setup of a multi-domain network slicing. We deployed a prototype solution of our 5G Zorro platform on using open source technologies on the 5G Barcelona facility. And our results show that our mechanisms takes only a fraction of the time that is used for manual activities, such as slice scaling and the instantiation of new or redundant network services, etc. So our SLA transactions using the DLT technologies and our predictions using AI ops algorithms take only less than 4% of the time that it takes for the complete end-to-end activation of these end-to-end slicing mechanisms. While at the same time, the predictions that are produced about the service performance are accurate. Thank you very much, and I will be happy to answer your questions.